let's just switch places. There we go. I looked up limbo in Webster's dictionary, and it says that it's a border, an edge, the abode of souls barred from heaven through no fault of their own, a place of confinement, a place or condition of neglect or oblivion. We've all been there, that abode where we struggle with the needs of our child, caused through no fault of our own or of our child. A place of social, yes, you're right, isolation, a condition of neighborly neglect or oblivion. Trapped, hedged in by a guilt that no defies explanation, we accept what the world tells us we're supposed to feel. You must love your child, the world says, and intermittently we do. As my wise daughter-in-law has said, it's easy to love people when they're lovable, not so easy when they're not. The inconstancy throws us off, floods us with a raging shame. Only in private do parents ask me, do I ever get angry? What do I do with these feelings, they ask? How do I take care of my child and hold myself together? They're old feelings, old questions. They turn up in Psalm 42. Why art thou cast down, O my soul? And why art thou so disquieted within me? Long ago, I thought that psalm was about those on the autism spectrum. Now I know the psalm is about us. And with it comes another question. How do I cope with the physical task of caring for my child and at the same time present myself to the world as the world says I'm supposed to be? The world says my child is a gift, a special gift that will transform me into a deeper, more meaningful person. But it's not happening. My child is driving me crazy. My child is isolating me from the world. So in order to join the world and have my neighbors think well of me, in place of love, I will substitute glory. I will glorify my child, praise every step forward. I will tell the world my child is special. And our children, trapped in autism self-absorption, assume the assigned role. In truth, we've given them no other choice. Out of our own need, we've created a role-making partnership. Our children are special, we are noble. And the neighbors, out of their need for approval, accept the partnership. They too find our child a handful. They too have feelings they don't want to say out loud. Thus, with mutual need, we construct limbo. We're all of us excused. We're all of us there through no fault of our own. It feels safe, but it's not. Limbo is a static condition, a place where nothing grows. It only repeats. Growth. Real growth takes courage, honesty, hard work, and insight. The setup of it reminds me of an old dog racing story back in the days when we used to race whippets. The oval track and the starting gate were the same as those on a horse race. Only instead of a jockey with a whip, there was a mechanical rabbit set on to scamper ahead of the dogs, always just out of reach. In this particular race, the bell clanged, the gates opened, and the dogs sprang out after the mechanical rabbit, all except for one dog. He stopped. He looked at the track. He saw that it circled around. He ran around the track the other way, met the rabbit, and chewed it up. He didn't win. Racetracks are about betting, not intelligence. But in my heart, he was the winner. You don't have to chase the mechanical rabbit just because the other dogs do. Stop. Take a look. It could be your escape from limbo. In your escape, you will find your child and yourself. And with Julia's Emmy, Your Emmy, the Emmy, will free us to go further than we thought we could go.